What's up, guys? What's going on? Welcome to another video. On this video, I'm going to be installing a head unit on my Yukon. Actually, right now, I'm on my way to pick up my girls. And as soon as I get back home, I'm gonna be doing all the wiring from the exterior, because I still want to keep the steering wheel controls. Let me turn the camera. So you guys can see I'm on my way to get my girls, but I still want to use so I can change the song, lower the volume on the steering wheel, and that will go away. So that's what's coming up next. Like I said, as soon as I get I get back home, I'm gonna be wiring the interface brain into the head unit. So show you guys in a little bit. All right, guys, this is the head unit that I'm gonna be putting on the Yukon Pioneer. Let me turn it around. Right here is a ABH 2550 NEX. And since I still want to use the steering wheel controls in it, I went and got this interface replacement. Here's the part number. And this is what I will do. It'll keep your OnStar steering wheel controls, orange images, and amplifier audio system. So this is what I will make, what I will keep the steering wheel controls and the voice system. And on this tiny numbers in there, I think it's set up on 0, and for Pioneers I need to put it on 7 before I install it. So I gotta turn that into a 7. This is all the wire hardeners that comes with it. And once you get all this done, I mean, it's supposed to be a plug and play. The antenna adapter and instruction. So, all right, I'm gonna start all the wiring, and I'll show you guys once I'm all done. All right, guys, I already finished with the wire harness. Got all the connections, heat shrink and everything. So this is the one that goes into the head unit, that goes into the brain. And these two will go to the factory connections in the Yukon. So then this will plug right here. And then this connection right here, what it does is to retain the steering wheel controls that will go in the bigger one. Right here. And then next to him, this is the one for the microphone, which is in here. It's a bit smaller. So that will go in there. And then this USB port, that's so we can use the Apple CarPlay, which that's the reason why I got this too. And then that's the other side of it. So I gotta find a place where to put it in my truck or SUV. And this is the antenna adapter. This will fit in here, because the stack, it won't fit in there. So it's a little smaller. So there you have it. So, I mean, I guess it's a little late tonight, so I just probably install it tomorrow morning. before I head out to work. So yeah, I'll show you guys how the installation tomorrow. As you can see, I already took this off. Just gonna put it in the back. And in order to remove the stack radio, there's 3 7mm bolts that we gotta take out. There's two on this side. So I'm gonna remove them. All right, those are the only two plugs that you need to take off from the stack head unit and the antenna. And like I said before, this one won't fit on the new head unit, so that's why we need the adapter for it. All right, I got it all plugged in. So now before I put it, I put everything back together. I'm just gonna test and see if everything works like it should. Let me connect my phone to it. Well, it sounds way better. Now let me see if the steering wheel works. Everything works, even to change the song. All right, now I'm just gonna put everything back together. And yeah, it's way better to have the Bluetooth than the stock one. All right, let me put this back together. All right, guys, I finished installing the head unit and I think it turned out great. Like I said, I was able to retain the steering wheel controls, and the sound is way better. I mean, it's more powerful. And like I said, I'll be installing subwoofers, rear camera. That'll be probably in the next 2 or 3 weeks. So yeah, you guys probably want to stay tuned. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks.